What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. I'm gonna try and keep it real with you in this video. Sometimes I absolutely am no good at trading. Like, everything I touch seems to hit stop loss, nothing's going right, I look like a loser, I look like I have no profitability to my trading, and I'm gonna address that. Because it really is true. If you've been watching along with my channel, maybe you've seen some of my live trading videos and noticed that I've had a losing streak lately, or maybe you're inside of our private group and you've seen, you know, that I'm taking a couple losses in a row and things are not looking so good. In today's video, I'm going to address why that may be, why I, in most situations, almost all situations, that is completely normal and part of my trading. And I'm gonna try and give you some insight so that maybe if this happens in your own trading, you can sort of understand it and maybe piece some things back together. So with that said, let's jump into the video. Okay, so the first thing I wanna say, I'm gonna back out of this really quick, and I wanna actually show you guys a comment that was received on my YouTube channel just recently. Now, the first thing I wanna show you is I wanna show you just my equity chart. So this is my FX book where I track my trades, and what you'll notice here is that if we look at this, you can notice that there are some really interesting, notable features of my equity chart. So what you'll notice is that there are these occasional big spikes that are awesome, right? And then if you really look at it closely, you'll also notice that there's these really unimpressive periods of time where I am mostly like flat or even just break even or even negative in my trading. And in today's video, my goal is to address this. Why do I have periods of time where I'm trading like a beast? And then I have these long periods of time where I trade poorly, or I am losing money, or I'm just break even and barely making anything. Well, again, that's the goal of this video. So I actually received a comment, and I really thought it was a very, very honest and good question. Jeremiah here says, looks like 90% of your profit was made within 3 to 5 days out of 250 trading days. I like your content, but you know very well that it is not consistent whatsoever. Is there a link to your MyFX book to see your stats? Well, yes, you can actually go to myfxbook.com and look for my account there. That's easy to do. You can grab that and look at the accounts that I have posted up there. But anyways, I wanna address this because I thought that this was actually a really, really good point. Why is it that out of all of this trading performance, that for the most part, it really comes down to a very select few trades? Let's count them again. One trade here, two trades, three trades. I'm gonna say four and maybe five within there, six, and then seven, eight, nine. So out of all of this, let's say 9 really good trades out of all of this time. Let's address why that is, because this is about just under a year of trading data. So you're really saying that in all that time, Nick, that you only really had 9 hot streaks that made you majority of the profit? Well, the answer is absolutely yes. Let's go look about it and let's talk about this in more detail. So again, there are periods of time where my trading based on an equity chart looks a lot like this. You get these big spikes up where things are great, and then you just get these annoying, degrading downturns that are slow, painful, little bits and pieces chipped off the account. And then hopefully another nice spike, a nice period of time where things are going well. Again, followed by down, annoying, your trading stinks, and then a spike. And then again and again and again. This is what my equity charts tend to look like. Why is that? Because I am a trend trader. Now, my strategy, which I like to call the TFF, wait, TTF, sorry, I said that wrong, TTF, which I sort of coined as my own little phrase, I call it true trend following. Now, there's of course trend following, but I like to call it true trend following because I don't use a strict take profit on my trading, which even more amplifies this concept, where I will occasionally take these amazing trades, and then a lot of my trades will be very unimpressive or even break even. Why is that? Well, if you think about a chart, right? And you think about the way a chart may move, right? For the most part, a lot of the times, maybe 70% of the time, you've heard that markets don't trend a whole lot. They go sideways, right? And then very occasionally, you get these incredible pulses in the market, these big trends. And it's very difficult to know exactly when those trends are going to occur. It's not as easy as just filtering them out. Like some people will say, oh, well, Nick, just wait till all the moving averages line up. And sure, I like to add those filters, but they're never 100%, and it's never perfect to know exactly when the market's gonna trend beautifully. Otherwise, we'd all be zillionaires, right? So my trend trading style, I tend to trail stops, which means I don't take a strict profit, which even more, you know, with a trailing stop, one of the common misunderstandings of, or annoying parts of a trailing stop is, let's say that you decide to get long here and the price goes in your favor and you trail your stop here and then you get tagged out. That happens occasionally. It's very, very annoying, but it's part of trend trading, especially my style, which is that true trend following method that I talk about inside of the group. Inside of our VIP, I have a downloadable file where you can read about my strategy. But anyways, the point is, every once in a while, I'll take something where I buy, let's say this was actually a buy trade, and I'm able to trail my stop all the way up here, right? And I finally get stopped out for a massive profit, creating one of these spikes in my equity chart. This is the nature of my trading style. I take a lot of little losses, and it can be very, very annoying. And it's not a trading style that I recommend for everybody, because not everybody likes this style where you take lots of little losses, take lots of break-even trades, and your win rate is not that impressive, right? So in the end, what happens in my trading style is that during this time, I'll just be completely honest with you. During my trading, right, because I share a lot of what I do on YouTube and on my private Discord, what ends up happening is that during times like this, people really don't, I'm just gonna be honest with you. I get a lot of negative comments. I get people who don't think that I'm, you know, doing the right thing. They think that my style is stupid, right? So I'll get a lot of negative feedback, right? And I'm telling you this because this is the truth, right? This is really what I experience. You know, one of the things that I don't wish on anybody, you guys, is if you are to share your content and to share your life as a trader, imagine if everything that you did as a trader and you sort of beat yourself up for, imagine if everyone else was also looking over your shoulder. And that's kind of, you know, I'm not complaining, but that's the world of being a social media person that also shares trading content. The reality is that you get a lot of negative feedback when things are not going your way. And even though I'm talking about this on social media, you may experience it within your own head, right? You may experience, wow, I suck at trading. I am horrible. Everything I touch is just awful and I should just quit this stuff because I'm no good, right? Have you ever felt that way about your trading? Because if you haven't, then you're lying. And maybe you haven't traded long enough, because it happens to all of us. It doesn't matter who you are. There's periods of time where you just feel a little bit of doubt. You feel a little frustration. Things are not working out, right? And then let me tell you the other flip side. The greatest side of it is when things are going incredible and everyone gives you that positive feedback. Okay, and I'm gonna add to this feedback concept in a second, because I have an insight that may be helpful to you. During this time, obviously, I'll post up a video and, you know, things are going incredible. And I took a trade recently. I'll pop up the thumbnail of a trade that I took that net me like $6,000. It was my best trade of 2021. And you can see my smiling face. It was incredible. I felt so good about that trade because, you know, I stuck to the rules and I was able to do that concept where the trend just kept going and I was able to trail that stop and it worked out amazingly. And I wish every trade worked out that well, but it doesn't, right? And again, on those videos where things are not going well, I get tons of like, hey, Nick, you should have taken profit. Why are you trying to trail stops? Just take your profits. That's silly of you. And then during this time, everyone's like, wow, that strategy works. You're amazing. You know, things like that. Now, I have a very important message for you that I think everyone should hear. Even though you may not be sharing content on YouTube or publicly, and you don't have that sort of public stress that you know some of the YouTubers do have, you have it within your own head, right? You really do. And let me give you a little bit of advice that took me a long ways. The sooner that you realize that even in my sort of situation where I do have that large following and I do also have those voices in my head, the best thing you can do about positive and negative feedback is ignore both of it. And this is the cold hard truth that myself being in this seat of, you know, of creating content, having people watch my content, and also having to live with myself with my trading, right? When things are going well and things are not going well. At the end of the day, the rule of thumb that I have learned to best approach this, to handle these things, is to avoid letting myself feel so good about myself and avoiding also allowing myself feel too negative about myself. it's weird because you might say, well, what the heck? Like, you should feel good about yourself when things are going well. What's wrong with feeling good about yourself? But I actually borrowed this concept from a gentleman named Gary V. Maybe you know him, Gary Vaynerchuk. He's a very popular social media guy. And he talks about this with comments, right? As any sort of creator, or just individual, you receive so much criticism and praise in your day-to-day task. And if you live in the world where you just adhere to the negative feedback and you give into it and you let it destroy you, and at the same time, you love getting the admiration from others, it's a constant battle and you never actually win, because positive feedback feels amazing, but if you give into that positive feedback and let it dictate how you feel, you also will get this, where this dictates how you feel as well, and you're only searching for this, but when you get this, it's destructive to you. Let me tell you guys, the only way I've been able to stay on YouTube, stay trading, stay through all of this stuff, it's a lot of stress. And the only way to do that really is to look inside and look for, you know, only one thing: feedback from yourself. Not just destructive feedback, but genuine. Look yourself in the mirror and say, hey, am I sticking to the rules? Am I doing things right? Am I being patient? And that's the point, is at the end of the day, I suck at trading sometimes. There are times where I'm an amazing trader though. And the whole point is, you're inevitably going to have periods of time like this and like this. You cannot avoid it. And again, one of the very common things that people do is during this time, they start looking for something to blame. What can I blame for my own mistakes and issues, right? This is also why I'm not a big fan of just copying other people's trades blindly. I'm actually a really, really big proponent of think for yourself. If you're going to be trading seriously, if you don't want to think for yourself, then look into things like passive investing, right? Long-term investing, things where you don't have to actually try and make decisions and work through the trading psychology, right? My opinion is that if you really want to take this stuff seriously, the only person that you should be blaming is yourself. If you make mistakes, look inwards, right? Find ways to take ownership, because again, you're never ever going to become profitable or successful in trading by blaming other people, blaming the markets, blaming some crazy tweet that came out that ruined your trading, right? If you're always doing that, you will never actually be able to produce something like this consistently, because what you're going to end up doing is you're going to go through the Forex death cycle, which is basically switching trading styles and making excuses and never actually taking ownership and doing the work that you need to do to become a profitable trader. This is the stuff that you won't hear anywhere else in my experience on YouTube. I haven't seen anybody making this sort of content. The no BS truth of the matter is that if you want to do well, you can't blame others. You got to work your butt off. You got to work through times like this in order to get to times like this, and accept that there will always be times like this. It is unavoidable. It is inevitable. And if you're looking for somebody to give you the holy grail, a secret strategy, you know, 100% foolproof signals that make you money every day, you're in the wrong industry. It's not that easy. It's very difficult. And the people who make it in the end, they work and they work and they work. One thing I always like to say is, think about this. You know those Wall Street people that make absolute millions and billions from trading? They handle client money, they work so hard. Well, if you ever notice, most of them are wearing suits and ties. Most of them, you know, work in a very, very aggressive and competitive atmosphere, and they work their entire lives to work those jobs. Think about that in respect and in comparison to the people sitting on the beach, flipping open a laptop and showing you cash. They're BSing you. They're showing you a world that doesn't exist. The people who really make money in this industry absolutely work for it. And if you're not ready to work for it, like I said, it's probably not the industry for you. And this is a video to wake you up, right? Again, I am not here to blow smoke on YouTube. I have not, you know, this following that I've built over time has not been just trying to hype or glorify trading in any way, right? The goal has been since day one to film my journey as a trader and to share what I've learned. And this is a concept and topic that is so important. At the end of the day, you've got to take ownership. You can't look for other people to blame. You have to accept that both of these scenarios are going to happen to you, especially if you're if your style matches with mine, where you just have losing streaks. One more thing I'll say is that maybe you have a different style. Maybe where you have a lower, you do take profits. You do trade differently than me, which is totally fine. But maybe your equity chart looks like this. right? If you're a good trader, right? You have more ups and downs because you are taking profits. You're notching in these win streaks. Again, every style has its challenges. You may have scenarios where, you know, you're looking at this and you're like, oh my gosh, if I had just on one of those trades, if I had just, you know, not taken profit and held on to a trailing stop, then I could have been up like crazy, right? Or if I moved my stop loss differently, I wouldn't have taken so many losses here, right? You can play the same hindsight games that are destructive to trading accounts until you can't see anymore and you can't think anymore, right? You can drive yourself crazy. But again, this is why psychology is so important, and accepting that we all suck at trading sometimes. Until you can get that through your head, it's gonna be very difficult to be profitable. So with that said, I feel like I've got to go put an ice pack on my forehead after all this. I feel like I'm aggressive today. I'm sorry if I attacked you today in this video. But again, I'm mostly responding to myself. My own journey here on YouTube has been why I've kept the content genuine, is because I'm trying to, you know, continuously learn and improve myself. This stuff is it's a journey that you can always learn more in. So with that said, that's why I love it, and that's why I'm sure a lot of you guys love it too. It's that continuous challenge, continuous learning. So if you enjoyed this video, do me a favor, hit that like button down below, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and I hope that you come back and join me for another one. We'll see you back next time. What's up, guys? Thanks for watching today's video. There are more videos available on our channel here and here, so go ahead and click into that for some more free trading content. With that said, thanks for watching. We'll see you back next time.